Hi, in the last video, I explained about the world's first satellite with onboard AI processing, a nanosatellite launched by ESA in partnership with Intel by using a commercially available chip called Movidor's Mirai 2 that is commonly found in some drones and smart devices. For more information, you can check out the link above or see the description below. So now, we will see how these onboard AI processing in satellites will help us from space and change our future. We will discuss some of the applications of AI satellites, especially with the satellite imagery and other Earth observation data.
But we need to get going because time is not on our side. In fact, if there's one positive thing that can come out of the Ebola epidemic, it's that it can serve as an early warning, a wake-up call to get ready. If we start now, we can be ready for the next epidemic. Thank you.
AI in a satellite can probably stop the next pandemic like COVID-19 or at least stop it from spreading to a larger area. Geographical information system and satellite image processing can give useful information for the discovery and management of both human and animal disease outbreaks. The satellite observation and AI can also be used for monitoring several environmental variables such as temperature, rainfall, humidity, wind speed, and direction, along with so many other factors that can help to predict an outbreak in very early stages and stop it from spreading. Satellite observation has already been used in the study of several water and vector-borne diseases such as diarrhea, cholera, typhoid, and other virus diseases. So how will these AI satellites monitor and look for any early stages of an outbreak such as COVID-19? Consider that the AI system already has information on the COVID-19 pandemic and its historical data. So with this data, the satellites will be monitoring happenings around a live animal market, biological labs, and even some animal farming industries. If AI satellites are seeing that the live animal market suddenly has less activities with very few people going in and out of the market, and if nearby car parking seem to be empty, then this is a strong signal for the satellite to focus its monitoring around that area. Satellites can also monitor for any possibilities of lockdown and even find out if more people are visiting nearby hospitals and clinics. So even if the local experts try to hide these activities, real-time notifications from satellites will help other government groups and organizations like WHO to find out if there is an outbreak and then take necessary actions. This was an example, but in reality, satellites and AI algorithms will be monitoring and going through thousands of possibilities before alerting or coming to a conclusion. A company called Blue Dot was among the first companies to predict the outbreak and spread of COVID-19. They process thousands of variables and online data each day, almost in real time, to predict an outbreak and its spread. So combining these data along with satellite imagery and real-time monitoring with AI will have higher chances for accurate predictions. 2019-20 Australian bushfire. A bushfire season that continued for almost a year was one of the worst disasters that we have seen in recent history, which destroyed close to 6,000 buildings and killed at least 35 people. According to WWF Australia, nearly 3 billion animals, which include mammals, reptiles, birds, and frogs, were killed or displaced by Australia's shocking 2019-20 bushfires. To be more exact, it is about 143 million mammals, 2.46 billion reptiles, 180 million birds, and 51 million frogs. About 19 million hectares were burned down, which included 12.6 million hectares of forest and bush. This is just one of the incidents. Similar large wildfires happen in different parts of the world, including the Amazon forest, a huge land area forest that controls and balances out almost 25% of the carbon dioxide produced worldwide. Such fires are also common in other parts of Asia and South America. Losing a large forest area and a natural habitat for billions of animals is affecting and creating a greater imbalance in nature. So how can technology and AI help in this? New advanced remote sensing AI satellites with very little response rates will be able to track down the location of fire immediately during an occurrence and be able to alert authorities on the ground. More information like the exact location, extent of the fire, how it's changing or moving out to other locations can be informed in real time from space without waiting a day or two for images to be downloaded and sorted out in ground stations. A well-trained AI system with deep learning technology can take decisions immediately and can stop a huge loss. And of course, satellites can also track down survivors, including humans and animals that will need immediate care. Everything should start from the base causes such as climate change and deforestation. We are already using AI systems on Earth for tracing changes in temperature, sudden variations in climate, and even studying signs for natural disasters. But to download millions of images from satellites and to sort out and analyze them using machines and with qualified scientists on Earth are still time-consuming. So sorting out and some decision-making should start with AI on satellite itself. Using historical data and with human-like thinking, AI should be able to predict the next natural disaster much in advance. Recently, efforts were done to map out every single tree on Earth using neural networks. Using satellite images, algorithms were trained to identify each tree, although trees will be seen only as a small pixel in images. But with enough training through labeled data, it was possible to make AI decide and map out each tree individually based on their shape, size, and color. This was not easy. It involved going through the hard process of identifying and labeling nearly 90,000 trees at first. Without a system like AI, it would have taken millions of people years to identify the trees and separate them individually. Recently, NASA also came up with a breakthrough technology using supercomputers and machine learning algorithms for mapping the location and size of trees growing outside of forests. So by mapping these technologies and data to AI satellites on orbits, we would be able to predict in real time carbon dioxide levels and even track down any activities related to illegal deforestation with greater accuracy. Remember that deforestation is still one of the major causes of climate change and wildfires. Oil prices are usually linked to global economic stability. As oil prices increases, it generally increases inflation and reduces economic growth. Likewise, oversupply or overproduction of oil will also have impacts on different countries depending on if they are a major producer or a consumer. We have seen all the fear and confusion when oil prices went negative during these COVID-19 lockdowns, as demand for crude oil was cut down by at least 20% or more globally. Still, we are on a recovery path trying to balance out the supply and demand. As most of the storage tanks have floating top, it's easy to calculate its volume and amount of oil in it by utilizing very simple trigonometry to estimate liquid level in a container. Monitoring these storage tanks from satellites, along with the study of available reserves and activities on oil wells, can help any government and oil management agencies to keep track of available oil resources. And this will benefit to an extent in balancing out the supply and demand, which already have an effect on the global economy. Oil spillage and fire accidents during production or even during sea or road transportation can also be monitored and tracked in real time using AI satellites. According to official figures, it's estimated that an elephant is killed every 50 minutes and more than 100 African elephants are killed in a day. We have already discussed how AI is helping to map out each tree on Earth. The same applies to animals as well. AI will have to be trained with huge sets of data and satellite images. With onboard real-time processing for remote sensing images and advanced AI, we will be able to identify and track animals and look for any unusual activities from poachers surrounding wildlife reserves. Currently, many wildlife sanctuaries and parks make use of fixed AI cameras and drones to monitor animals for any illegal activities like poaching. But to cover hundreds and thousands of miles of land area and forest, and to track thousands of animals, satellites and AI will make more sense. Although monitoring and timely alerts are possible through satellite imagery, a good system still needs to be placed on the ground for anti-poaching missions, or in a way, both AI satellites and ground technologies have to work together to be more efficient. Soon, AI satellites will be planning out all our infrastructure development by telling us where to plan for the next railway lines or pointing us to the perfect land area for the next tunnel or underground system. During the recent India-China border issue, we have seen how they made use of satellite images to monitor movements and infrastructure developments near the border. Imagine what AI can do from space regarding border disputes and for planning out strategies for a battle. So possibilities are never ending, and an efficient AI system from space looking over the Earth can see everything. It has a lot of data and can act fast with advanced technologies like neural networks. AI satellites can also be installed to monitor hazardous environments such as nuclear sites. AI will be able to predict crop yields, its prices, and even recommend ideal places for the next agricultural land by studying climate, weather conditions, and soil types. AI on satellites will possibly bring us the next generation of efficient Google Maps or communication system to recommend routes for diverting traffic and to give timely information on real-time incidents. We'll be seeing drones controlled by AI satellites and even probably see airplanes rerouted or tracked down by satellites during emergencies. SpaceX is using AI to keep its satellites from colliding with other objects in space. AI is used to control the navigation of satellites and other spacecraft. Artificial intelligence is working to make space commercialization a possibility and to make space a safe environment to operate. Once again, SpaceX was in the news lately for commercial space flights a few days back by taking 4 astronauts from NASA to the International Space Station. Access to powerful AI processor in space and using humanoid machines for space exploration will lead to a future with more exciting discoveries that we never imagined. Finding and exploring more planets with similar conditions to that of Earth will become more common. Recently, artificial neural networks helped in recognizing about 50 such planets. We might even find another planet with living beings or with another human-like species who are living with technologies that are thousands of years ahead of us. Anyway, to have AI in space is not very straightforward. It needs a lot of testing and special hardware. But even to design this special hardware and programs, our existing AI technologies can help. I'll be closely watching all the progress of AI in space and will keep you updated. Hope you enjoyed this video. Do subscribe, like the video, and share this information with your friends. See you again. Bye.